Speedway most of the day today, and I don't know that I've ever felt it quite that hot along the coast this time of year. It's just brutal out there.
Hope you had your sunscreen on.
Nah, not so much.
Yeah, I know. Jason, he needs to wear his sunscreen.
You've got to. I mean, come on, this is Central Florida and a lot of sunshine right now. Although I do expect some increasing clouds as we head into Saturday and Sunday afternoon as the remnants of Emily try to draw up into Central Florida. So let's go ahead and talk about that. Remnants of Emily down to the south approaching the Florida Straits, slowly reorganizing now over very warm 85, 87 degree water between Cuba and the Bahamas. Beneficial rain is more likely for Central Florida as we continue to watch the remnants get closer to us. Here's a look at the path over time. Came through the Lesser Antilles, was disrupted, as we thought, by Hispaniola, Haiti, and even eastern Cuba. And now the remnants of it are just here to the south of the Bahamas, still interacting with Cuba as well. But remember, we talked about that weaker system scenario, the western track of the models, and that is indeed the case, this weaker area of low pressure getting shoved farther to the west. So it's more likely this will just kind of drift up into South Florida, not have much time to develop. But either way, it just means higher rain chances Orlando southward, I think, for tomorrow. And then by Sunday, offshore winds, the beaches get those offshore moving storms, and the rain coverage remains at about 50%. So there's a sneak peek at your weekend out. Outlook. We'll be monitoring any potential developments with Emily. Hurricane hunters may go check it out tomorrow if there is time. But for tonight, a few storms moving to the west. Marion to Lake to Polk County. Watch out for a sea breeze collision. We may see a couple of bigger storms pop up later this evening. Also, temperatures, the big story, mid to upper 90s. I-4 west, still 90 to 91 at the beaches. Overnight lows will be in the mid to upper 70s, so we're still on the warmer side of average once again. And then afternoon highs tomorrow, mid 90s around Orlando and Sanford, but 90 to 91 along the coast. We'll still have all the moisture around, but a little extra cloud cover, a little higher rain chance. Looks like the best coverage of rain tomorrow, Cocoa Beach, 50%, 40% heading northward due to the approach of some of that deeper moisture from the remnants of Emily. Now, your 7-day forecast shows temperatures 89 at noon tomorrow, but watch out for those midday and afternoon storms developing. On Sunday, we might have a better chance of a few showers developing earlier in the day. Moving to the east, though, off the coast, that's the pattern change for the weekend by Sunday. Early next week, we're going to keep rain chances near normal, 40-50%. Martha, Jim, back to you.